Today I'm talking about one of the bad habits that we scientists and engineers tend to pick up in graduate school, and that habit is working alone, feeling we have to do everything ourselves. This is a habit that can really hamper us when we get into an industry career. So if you find you have this habit yourself, keep watching. Hey everybody, Dave Giltner with Turning Science. I'm still on the road. If you've watched the last few of my videos, you know I've been recording them from somewhere other than my office. I'm still in Germany today, so instead of my office, you're seeing me recording from my Airbnb in Würzburg, Germany. So as scientists and engineers, we can pick up a number of bad habits in graduate school. And I'm going to be doing a series of videos on these topics. But today, I want to talk about the first one, which is the tendency to want to work alone, or the habit of always feeling like we have to do everything ourselves. That's not at all the way the world of industry works, the way the real world works. In industry, speed is important. Companies have to move quickly because there's always deadlines and competition. And if you try to be the expert, or if you try to do all the work yourself, you will not be going very quickly. Now, of course, this is not at all what we were trained in graduate school. If you're standing up for your master's defense or your PhD defense, and somebody asks you a challenging question, you can't look for somebody else to help you out with it. You would fail. That would not work. And yet, in the real world, that is exactly what is expected of you. So this was really driven home to me recently, about 6 months ago, when I was watching the CEO of a startup pitch his company. And he happened to be a biologist, a PhD biologist. And in the middle of the presentation, he commented, "I found that graduate school actually prepared me for the opposite of the real world. It taught me to work alone. And the one thing I've learned starting a company and working out in the real world is that you have to rely on other people." And this really struck me because I found the same thing myself. So I want to let you know what I did to break that habit, because I certainly struggled for a long time kicking the habit of feeling I need to do everything myself. What helped me was to remind myself, industry doesn't reward expertise working alone. Industry rewards fast and efficient results. And if I'm trying to do everything myself, I cannot be as fast and efficient as my company needs or my boss needs. To help you break this habit, I suggest you find some way to remind yourself of this on a regular basis. And there's a lot of ways you could do it. You could write it on a post-it note and stick it on your computer monitor. You could set an alarm on your calendar to go off every morning to remind you, be fast and efficient, work with others. You could even post it somewhere in your office where other people might see it. Say, be fast and efficient, or something that reminds you. Now, the interesting thing about this, if other people can see it, you may get some questions about it. And you have the opportunity to teach them as well. If they ask, why do you have this on your wall? You can say, you know, graduate school trained me to be the expert. It trained me to always work alone. And I found that it's really important to work with others to achieve results, the fast and efficient results that my company needs, that my boss needs. And so I post that there to remind myself. Not only might you help other people who ask about it, but that kind of interaction, describing it to other people, can really help you get it in your mind and change your own habits. This is what I did to break that habit myself, and it took a few years before I was consistently looking to others for help rather than trying to do everything on my own. But it was really important, and it made a big difference in my career. It will make a big difference in your career as well. That's all I have to say today about that bad habit we pick up in graduate school of working alone, of feeling we have to be the expert and do everything ourselves. If you like this video, please click that like button. It'll help me, but more importantly, it will help other people who could benefit from this video, because more likes means YouTube shows it to more people. And if you'd like to get more videos like this yourself, click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. I post about 2 of these videos a month to help you design the career you really want. Thanks for watching. Now let's get out there and turn science into things people need.